Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my YouTube channel, and in this playlist we are covering about JavaScript interview questions. In last couple of videos, like 10 to 15 videos, I cover all different questions about array and strings, where you have a problem statement and you have to write the algorithm, pseudocode and the actual implementation. Okay, we will go further on that, and we will also explore more questions, because there may be a set of good number of questions, like 50 plus questions. If you even go through them once, then you will become aware, okay, these are some of the tricky questions which may be asked in the interview questions, like string reversals, removing the duplicates, finding all the permutations and combinations of a string, right? How to convert a byte array into a string, how to fetch the duplicate characters from the string, how to find the longest known repeating sequence from a string, right? Palindrome, anagram, these are very basics. How you can find out that there are two strings are substring of one another, okay? Then we have like how to print first known repeated characters. So one common thing which you will identify is either you deal with a string or an array. One thing which is common in most of the questions is you have to create a map of the characters. Okay, in the string I will create a map of the characters, and rest I can just iterate onto the map and can identify what is the problem statement it is and how can I solve it. A simple problem statement is like where you want to just identify that what is the count of individual character. So simple problem is what is the count of individual character inside a string. In that case you will be able to find out first repetitive character, all duplicate characters. Okay, you can also find out, you can also remove the duplicate characters from that string. Okay, so what we will do is first we will try to find out all possible ways to remove the duplicates from an array. So that we have already seen, like we just iterate on an array and we just do a loop onto it, removing the duplicates and creating the map. We will talk about both the things. So if you just look at this code, it's very helpful. First, we are actually creating the map of a string. Okay, so this function will always, like if the string is, if you're calling this function and you're passing a string, okay, so what output you are getting? You are getting an object which is saying, okay, H is occurring how many times? 1. L is occurring how many times? 3. So with the help of this, you will be able to identify, is the string having the duplicates, which character is occurring maximum number of times, and what all are duplicate characters. You will see duplicate characters where the count is greater than 1. If L is coming 2, twice or thrice, that means the count is greater than 1. That means this character is duplicate in the string. Okay, so we can write any kind of code, like we can write a simple filter and find index of. It is same as you do remove duplicates from a string or an array. Like, so this is your string, and here you have hello world, and what you wanted to do is remove dupes. Okay, so you can actually do a simple new set. Okay, and inside that you can pass an array. And how to convert this into array? String dot split, it will convert this into an array and it will remove all the duplicates. Then you can join this array back to get the string, right? Or the simple logic is this: here we have converted the string into an array and then doing a filter, and filter will return only those elements whose index of is equal to the same index. I mean, it's a standard way of removing the duplicates from an array. So array index of I should be equal to the index of the element itself. If it is not, that means that character is coming at another place further in an array, where the index of the element is not equal to the index of function, because index of will always give you the value of the first index in array. So like if I talk about this, right? Here, when you iterate 1, 2, 3, 4, that is fine. But when you start iterating 1, 2, 3, 4 again, the index of 1 will always be 0. But the array index, the position will be 4. That is not equal, so it will not return that element. Similarly, you can also use simple new set for removing the duplicates from an array. Okay, I mean, here we have the string, so we have to split that, convert into an array, then converting it back to the string. Okay, so this is how we actually deal with the duplicates in our code. Okay, now consider reverse a string. You are thinking like this is a more basic problem in the strings, and it is very easily can be dealt with it because we have already done the split. So split will convert that string into array. Then what you can do is you can run reverse, and then you can do a join. A best way to reverse a string. What are the other ways? Consider that you are asked to write a recursive function to do the reverse of a string. Or what are other ways in which you can do a reverse? So here we will talk about that approach. We took a string as an input. Okay, here we will call it as a recursively. We will check string is there. Then we will recursively calling this reverse string. If string input is available, we will be using ternary operator. And here we will be passing substring of it, str.substring, string.substring, and we will be passing substring of 1, and we will be concatting. Once this is called, we will concat it with a string of 0. Okay, if string is coming as an empty, then just print the string. This is the recursive version of it. And other ways are also there, like const reverse. I took string as an input. I'm writing arrow function. So here, let's say string. Okay, let's say output. I'm returning this output. I will run for of loop. You can simply run for of loop on a string without converting the string into an array. Okay, always remember this, const c of string. And here what I will do is, it's just a trick. So what I will do is out equal to character plus out. So it will keep concatting after the occurrence of character. So it will indirectly reverse a string using just a simple iteration. So we are putting character first, then out is returned. The same out we are appending again after the character, right? So if your string is... Okay, so first of all, you will, if you just look at this iteration, character is h, right? So out will become h in the first iteration. In the second iteration, the character is e. So the value of c is e, character, plus the result from the previous iteration is h. Right, similarly, next iteration is l, and the result from the previous iteration was eh. Okay, it will keep adding and you will get a reverse of a string. Okay, so this is the recursive version of it. This is the plain and simple version of it. This is how you can simply reverse it. You can also do a reverse using reduce method after splitting the string. So, I mean string.split. Here I have converted it into an array, so I can run reduce. Reduce, you know, map, filter, reduce, all these methods are there. It takes two arguments, accumulator and the value. Okay, here you just need to see this. And you are initializing it with an empty array. Right, so it will keep passing the result into the second value. This is the character, this is the accumulator function, this is the character. Okay, so it is same logic as written like this. Reduce method is also doing the same. Okay, so these are most common questions and very basics. So you should never do the mistakes, at least in these questions. Okay, apart from that, if we go and talk about this now, how do you remove a given character from a string? You will just run a split. You will just run a filter on this, right? what you will do is you will just run a filter on the given string. What you will do is, okay, I need to remove, okay, it was something like this. Okay, so consider that you have given a string and character. What you need to do is, first you will convert it into a array, okay, and here you can just run a simple filter. What you will return is, if I is not equal to character, you will return only those elements, and you can put a return statement here. So it will actually return the array, and you can also do a join, so you will get a string back. Okay, now remove all duplicate, that is fine. Remove the find maximum occurring character in a given string. Find maximum occurring character of a string, right? So if I just put it, now what we need to do, we need to take the help of this map of the string. What map of the string will give me? Map of the string will give me the map object. Okay, so what I will do is, here I will write const maximum occurring character. Here I pass a string, this is my arrow function. So what I will do is, I will get an object first by calling this map of string, and I will pass a string. So what this object will give me, we just need to do a for in loop, let I in obj. Here you can say, okay, okay, the character is, you can create a variable maximum character is obj of I, so that will give you the value. So what we just need to do is, let's put it as a string of, so this string is a string, so we can actually do a split, it will give me the array and zero. So what I'm saying is, consider that maximum character is the first character of the string, but here we will do a keep comparison, maximum character and its value is 1. We are considering that first character is at least appearing for the one time, that is our assumption. Now if object of I, so that is actually value, object of I is greater than, object of I is greater than the max value, that means there is another character which is occurring more than the first character. So here we will just replace both of these values, maximum character and maximum value. Maximum character becomes the I, and maximum value become object of I. And finally, once this loop is done, console.log, or you can return character. So max char, it will give you the character which is occurring maximum in a particular string. And you can also put the count, max value, I mean, which character is occurring and how many times it is. Okay, so rest all questions on the string we'll cover in the next. There are still the counting, the permutation combinations, a sliding window problem. These are most common questions in the string.